There is speculation that Mitt Romney applied a self-tanner to dye his face brown before addressing a town hall on Spanish language TV. Speculation? He looks like my dad's recliner.
Saturday Night Live there, making light of Mr. Mitt Romney's somewhat darkened appearance. But it wasn't just his complexion that captured attention at the Univision town hall. It was also the size and sound of the audience's reaction. Wow. Turns out they couldn't find enough Republican students at the University of Miami, so instead of allowing any student into the event, Romney threatened to cancel unless his campaign was allowed to bus in some supporters to fill the empty seats. And that wasn't their only demand. Joining us now are Maria Teresa Kumar, who's an MSNBC contributor, and Liliana Gil Valletta, who is co-founder of the XL Alliance. Maria, the co-moderator of that Univision town hall, said Romney's actions, and I'm quoting her, were disrespectful. She also said that he demanded retaping the opening of the show because he didn't like the introduction. It sounds as if, unless Mitt Romney is given the Fox News Network treatment, he just throws all the toys out of his pram.
Well, it sounds like Mitt Romney doesn't know how to campaign, and he doesn't know how to actually bring reporters into his camp. I have to share with you, Maria Elena Salinas is highly respected in the Latino community. Whatever she says pretty much goes. And the fact that she said that was disrespectful, that speaks volumes to the Latino community, that not only were they disrespecting her, but Mitt Romney was actually disrespecting the forum and his ability to talk to the Latino community.
So not such a great win for him.
Not at all.
Liliana, the author Ann Coulter made some interesting remarks. I'd like you to listen to these.
We don't owe the homeless. We don't owe feminists. We don't owe women who are desirous of having abortions, but that's or gays who want to get married to one another. That's what civil rights has become for much of the left. They drop the flags after 5 minutes.
Immigrant rights are not civil rights?
No, I think civil rights are for blacks.
Immigrant rights are not civil rights?
Apparently not. And I guess not all people are, you know, can enjoy the personal liberty that the 13th and 14th Amendment in this country ought to give them, regardless of race and ethnicity and gender and personal preference. So she is just showing us how her personal bias is getting in the way of the obvious good decision making that anyone looking at the emerging majority minority in this country ought to be paying attention to. So it was ignorant, and she looks ignorant, and unfortunately, once again, it's another dent in the party that is trying or claiming to say that they want to outreach, you know, Latinos.
Maria Teresa, do you think that Ann Coulter represents the views of Mitt Romney to any extent?
Well, I think, first, I don't, I mean, to be fair, but I think that he hasn't been able to come clean when it comes to his whole notion of what immigration should be. He still hasn't said that he doesn't believe in self-deportation. He still believes, when he talks about the DREAM Act, he believes only in young people serving in the military. And when you start talking about immigrant rights, you're talking about who in America is not an immigrant. And when you're talking about that you don't believe in the fundamental belief of what our bedstone of America is, then you're basically un-American, Ann Coulter.
Yeah, indeed. I mean, she says, you know, we're not ones who are desirous of having abortions or gays who want to get married to one another. That's what civil rights has become for much of the left. They drop the blacks in 5 minutes. And George Stephanopoulos says immigrant rights are not civil rights. And she says, no, I think civil rights are for blacks.
And you know what the reality there is? It's not so much that the Democrats haven't dropped blacks, but Republicans have dropped blacks and Latinos, and the realization that there is a changing face of America that is driving growth, that impacts the economy, and that is going to make a significant difference in who makes it to the White House.
Right, and I think what's happening is that Ann Coulter and Mitt Romney, they've basically gone all the way to the right, that even Republicans themselves may not be identifying with their own party. So they're turning off potential voters that are moderate Republicans and also independents. And that's the worst for their party. You can say that they're right now becoming the sunsetting party because they're going so extreme to the right.
Indeed. Maria Teresa Kumar in person. Liliana Gil Valletta, thank you both.